Hi there! Remember that video where we showed you how to use the curve line tool to create glowing lines with animated thickness? Well, what if we told you that's just the beginning? Ready to take it further and turn those lines into a unique text effect? Stick around and watch till the end. Let's begin by adding some text to the scene and adjusting its font and size. Click the text object and convert it into curve lines. When the pop-up window appears, leave all settings as they are and confirm the conversion. On the timeline, hide all letters except the first one. Now, double-click the second letter, press Ctrl+A to select all the points and copy them. Go back to Scene 0, open the first letter and paste the points there. Delete the extra curve line object that was inserted with the copied points. Next, select the lowest point and uncheck Closed Free Shape mode in the top toolbar to remove the unwanted connection line. Repeat this process for each letter in your text. Once you've connected all the letters, let's smooth out the transitions between them. To do this, click the first letter, hold Ctrl and drag a point to adjust its shape on the scene. Then, holding Ctrl, remove one of the bezier handles and fine-tune the other until the curve flows naturally. Apply this to every connecting segment. Now let's work on the line thickness. Press Ctrl+A to select all points, go to the Properties window and enable Thickness Control. Expand the section, deselect all points and then choose only the ones where you want to change the thickness. Assign the values that best match your design idea. Time to add some color. Apply a gradient to the line and feel free to experiment until you achieve the look you're after. With the design complete, let's animate it. Open the key editor for the starting position parameter. Add a keyframe at the 2-second mark. Set the initial value to 0, switch to bezier mode and adjust the curve to your liking. Do the same for the visible length parameter, but this time add a keyframe at 1 second. Now update the visual style. Set the line thickness to 7.5 pixels, feathering to 5 and blurring to 1. Then create two duplicates and move them underneath. For the middle copy, set thickness to 9, feathering to 15 and blurring to 10. For the bottom one, increase thickness to 15 and set both feathering and blurring to 15 as well. Next, convert the original text object on the timeline into a free shape, again without animation. Set the fill to transparent and the outline to white. With an outline thickness of 4. To apply gradient coloring, convert this new text into curve lines again. Assign individual gradients to each letter, then move them into the free shape and bring them to the top layer. select all the curves and set their thickness to 13, feathering to 5, and blurring to 30. Now, let's create a smooth text reveal using a mask. Draw a rectangle that covers the full text and set its fill color to black. Open the rectangle, apply the movement effect and set the starting point to the right of the text. Move the yellow marker to the 1 second mark and check if the text is fully revealed by then. Add Gaussian blur with a level of 50. Return to the high level and set the rectangle's blending mode to mask. The final touch is a leading line that enters from off-screen. Add a curve line object and draw a path towards the first letter's starting point. Set the first point's thickness to 400%. Animate the line's appearance and delay the drawing of all other objects until the line reaches them. To enhance this effect, stylize the line. Make the main line white with a thickness of 3, feathering of 30, and disable blurring. Create two duplicates and move them below. For the middle line, set the thickness to 35. Set feathering to 15 and blurring to 30. For the bottom line, go with a thickness of 75, feathering of 10 and blurring of 50. Feel free to tweak these values to suit your style. The core idea is to keep the top line thin and sharp, while the lower ones become progressively thicker and more blurred. Looking great so far. Now, let's briefly look at a second project to help you understand the concept even better. Here, a curve line was drawn and filled with a gradient. Thickness was set to 15, feathering to 40, and animation curves were adjusted using bezier handles. A duplicate of this line was placed underneath, with slightly tweaked animation and feathering settings. Blurring was increased to 100 for a soft glow. Another duplicate of the top line was created, this time with 4.5 pixel thickness and the overlay blending mode. Four more copies were made and spaced sequentially for a layered look. To add movement to the colors, the HSL effect was applied. And the hue levels were animated using a sinusoid wave, causing the gradient to shift continuously. All elements were then grouped into a sprite, where motion blur was enabled using the streak setting. Keyframes were added at the start of the animation, and the blur was later turned off for a clean finish. And that's a wrap! We hope this tutorial helped you unlock new ways to animate with the curveline tool. Do not forget to subscribe for more content. See you in the next video.